Hi, we zijn hier op de Musicmesse in Frankfurt met Andy van Akai. En we gaan hem wat vragen over de nieuwe NPC's van Akai. Hi Andy. So Akai is coming out with two new NPC's. We're here with the Renaissance. Could you give us a quick overview of the machine and point out some features and the difference between the studio and the Renaissance model?
Okay, now let's start off with why we've made these. Now, the NPCs have made hit records for about 25 years. So it's got to the point where everybody now works inside a computer. So we wanted to take the same workflow and the same work experience that you have on the NPCs and put it inside your DAW. So this is how the Renaissance came about. So when you walk up to the machine, you're working on an NPC. There's no different. The difference is we're now inside the box. So when we go around the machine, you'll see all the classic feature sets, which are all one touch that interfaces with the software. So we have our note repeat, we have 16 levels, and everything that I'm doing can be run from either the LCD screen or from the monitor. So I don't need to be zoned inside the computer. So everything I'm gonna do now, I have my BPM, I have my track selection, I have my sample edit so I can see my WAV files. Everything's on hand. So, you know, the controller is an absolute joy to work with. It's got the 3000 controller here. We have a great data wheel for spinning through, which is very similar to the 3000. Then we have our cue links on the left-hand side. Now, with the interaction with the computer, we needed a control system that enables us to not just control the parameters, but control virtual plugins, virtual instruments, etc., etc. Now, the difference between the Renaissance and the studio is nothing to do with the software, it's to do with the size and the internal sound card. Now, the Renaissance has its own built-in sound source because we put this new mode called vintage mode. So not only has it got the classic NPC look, you've got the NPC 3000 simulation and the 60. So when you turn these on, the sound chip will kick in and you will have that same 3000 sound. And then you hit the next feature and it now turns the machine into 12-bit.
That's a really cool option.
And then other is any emulation that we might want to put, like an SP1200, ASR10, etc., etc. So there's no limits, there's no restrictions. Input-wise, we've got turntable inputs, line levels, so we can sample into the software, which again is a big, you know, is a nightmare for some people because they're working inside the box. They're like, how do I sample in my computer? Well, you're sampling as if you were running hardware. So
plug it in.
Yeah, you've got it. Plug it in. Hit record. And now I can sample in, or I can even go resample. So I can resample my sample and stuff. So all those features are in the workflow. So let's go through some of the classic feature sets and some of the new stuff. Now, if I'm making a beat, it's no different to how it's always been. I just select my samples and I can start programming. So, comes up on the grid, so we can move it, edit it. Now, if I want to edit a loop, or I want to blend a loop into what I'm doing, this is one of the coolest features you'll ever see. So, if I take a loop, I can go sample, edit. I have a loop here. Yeah. I can now go to my cue links, which are already assigned, and go into this. But I want to chop it up. So I hit chop.
Wow.
I've now got access to different chop modes. Threshold, region, or BPM.
That's
now, amazing. If I want to do it by BPM, I can tell it how many regions I want to do. So I might do 8 regions. But this is the killer feature. I want to hear them, and I want to hear them on the pads. I might be playing my beat at the same time, and I hit audition, and now I can audition my slices before I've even committed to the edit. So I could chuck in another loop, I could chop it up, I could put it on the pads, see what it sounds like.
Hear what it does.
Yeah, and then take it out of audition, whilst it's still playing, go convert, go slice it, bang. I can now go back into my program mode, go to a new track, pull up my slices. We also have time stretch, so we could go edit, pull up our time stretch, and we know that pretty much everyone has been after this feature is using controllers. One of the other things, which is very important, we go to program, edit. If you want to layer our drums, very, very simple. right? We can simply go to a program, we'll go to a new program, go to track three. So I'm in my program, I've got a kick drum, go to program edit. I can now just pick up my layers and go, okay, I'm just gonna layer four samples on there. Right, I've now layered that quick. And if that's not enough, I can say, okay, I've got my layer, I wanna put up to four insert effects onto that one pad. So I might have a UAD card, I might have some, you know, Oxford EQs or whatever. I can just bring those up, put them straight on that one pad. Or I might wanna put a reverb on that pad. I might wanna, you know, I've got no limits. So once I've done all that, I think, oh, right, I wanna put some keyboard parts. I'm gonna have to take it into Logic. Well, you don't. We go to main menu, I go to track four, and I take it out of MPC mode and now go plugin mode. I can now open up all my VST virtual instruments. And,
really?
Yeah.
That's great.
And plug a keyboard into the MIDI in and do all my sequencing. All inside, comes up in the grid, I can edit, all inside the program. And then, once I'm happy with all the workflow that I've done, yeah, I can then simply go to File, Export, Audio Mixdown, send it out separate tracks, different file formats, go to Pro Tools,
and
go to the studio.
You import the tracks in Pro Tools, yeah, or Ableton or whatever.
Yeah, that's right, and then finish my mix.
Wow.
So the workflow is second to none. It really is. It's
really great.
Incredible workflow. Every button on here will operate the software. Uh-huh. I never need to use the mouse. I can either use here or I can edit on the screen. I have the choice. So it's very versatile.
Great, Andy. Thanks a lot.
It's all right.